Hello, my name is Aaron. In our last tutorial, we changed the proofing language in Microsoft Word for the PC. Today, we're going to change the proofing language in Word for Mac. The proofing language is the language Word uses to spell check your document and offer grammar suggestions. The bonus section at the end shows what to do if you don't see spelling and grammar suggestions in your text. I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365 for Mac. These steps will be similar in the one-time purchase versions of the software back to Word 2016 for Mac. To begin changing the proofing language, press Command plus A to select your entire document. Alternatively, you can select the Edit menu followed by Select All from the drop-down menu. Please note that Word won't use the new proofing language to check existing text unless the text is selected before changing the language. Next, select the Review tab in the ribbon, and then select the Language button. When the Language dialog box appears, select the language that you want to use. I'm going to switch from English in the United States to English in the United Kingdom. After making your choice, uncheck the Do Not Check Spelling or Grammar and Detect Language Automatically options. Select the Default button if you want to use the selected language in future documents. Finally, select the OK button. Your text should now be spelling and grammar checked in the selected language. If spelling and grammar suggestions don't appear in your text, ensure that your preferences are set to show in text corrections. To begin, select the Word menu, and then select Preferences from the drop-down menu. When the Word Preferences dialog box appears, select Spelling and Grammar. From there, ensure that Check Spelling as you type and Check Grammar as you type are both selected. When you're finished, select the Close button. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. For more Word for Mac tutorials, please see my playlist, How to Use Word for Mac, where you'll find many related videos, such as how to change the page background color in Word for Mac, and how to insert audio files in Word for Mac. All the resources mentioned today are linked in the description box below, along with my website, erinwrightwriting.com, which shows all the steps we just performed with images. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss upcoming tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.